as we try and find our way through. Slips in, Erling Haaland. No. Can he get the finish? He can.
Where's the keeper?
That was you.
The ePremier League finals are fast approaching, and today we are at Manchester City to talk everything FC24 and real life football. We are joined by 3-time Premier League winner Rodri, Argentinian FC24 pro player for Manchester City Esports, Mateus Bonanno, and then ePremier League winner Tekkz. We're going to go through and talk about, first of all, your ultimate dream team on FC24. So we're going to have some items to take a look at, and I want you to tell us who should make it into your team. To start off with, though, we need a goalkeeper. We have the choice of Team of the Year honourable mentions Edison or Icon Schmeichel.
In real life, I like Edison. He can play the passes.
Yeah.
But on the game, I prefer Schmeichel.
Okay.
So I'll leave up to Matty and Rodri to decide who we use.
Similar opinion. Schmeichel in the game, for me, is better. And so I chose Schmeichel.
Well, I'm going to go against this too. I'll pick my teammate. I don't know in the game, but in real life, he's so good, and I think he's rising the biggest level right now.
Tekkz, you got to pick one, though.
I think we're playing a 2v2 game very soon, and you're my teammate, so I don't want to make you angry. So okay. I'll choose Edison.
Moving over to the right back, you have the options of winter wildcard Kyle Walker or future stars Rico Lewis.
Difficult, eh? Difficult,
yeah,
tough. Very tough. Of course, Kyle, long time with him. He's a great guy. He's obviously now the captain and such a long career in the Premier League. And then Rico is the young star coming up, rising. I think he's a huge talent, so young. Basically, I would pick Rico because he's the future of the club. And Kyle is still a great player, but I would choose Rico, yeah.
So you're gonna go against the captain there? Kyle might not be too happy with that.
Nah, I mean, we have confidence between each other, and he will pick Rico also because he needs a push, so yeah. We will go for Rico.
That's fair enough.
I tried Walker, but I didn't try Lewis, so I prefer Walker with a new car.
Yeah, now I'll go Walker too. I used him in the last weekend league, so yeah, I'll say Walker.
All right, well, Walker in that right back position. At centre back, we have the options of Manuel Akanji or Nathan Ake.
Well, I love them too, to be honest.
Yeah.
I think they've been great signing for us. I would pick Nathan. I'll tell you why, because I think people didn't give the credit that he deserves. He's been unbelievable this season, last season. So I think I would go for Ake.
Tekkz, you think on FC24 you might want that little bit of extra pace that Akanji has to offer?
Nah, it's the pace and height. I think Akanji's a little bit taller. I think, I'm not sure on that, but. So yeah, I would choose Akanji.
Mateus?
They are similar players in the game. It's the same for me. I think it's Ake.
There we are then, that centre-back position locked in. But to partner it, we have the options of Team of the Year Ruben Dias or Manchester City legend and hero on FC24, Vincent Kompany. That's a tough decision.
I mean, I packed Kompany at the start of FC24 and he wasn't the best for me on the game.
Okay.
So for that reason, I go Team of the Year Ruben Dias every day of the week. So yeah, I'd go Dias.
Ruben Dias, I think, is better Team of the Year so far. Ruben Dias.
But yeah, I'm going to follow. I'm going to trust these guys. They know more the game. And yeah, I'm going to pick Ruben Dias, even though still he's, at the minute, the best centre-back in the history right now, Vincent Kompany.
Well, moving over into that left back position, we have the option of Gvardiol's radioactive item or Sergio Gomez, future stars as well.
Nah, I think Guardiol. I think if we're talking about the left hand side, you have to pick Guardiol. He's so young also, very mature, and I think lots of potential in the future.
It'd be very difficult to beat out that left back position, wouldn't he, Gvardiol, Tekkz?
I mean, I've not used either of them in FC, so I'll go for Gvardiol as well.
Yeah, for me the same. I prefer Guardiol, I think, for the crosses. He's so good. So.
On to our centre mid position, and you never guess what? We're going to have yourself, and we're not going to have the discussion whether you know you make it or
there's
not.
No other
you're
going to
be
eh?
Set. Yeah. Are you happy with that Team of the Year item?
Honestly, the last years not, but I think in this year's yes, the 95 seems very good.
Yeah, well, it goes up to 99 as the max. So, you know, you got 95 defending, 93
not,
physicality.
Not bad.
And I know so many FC24 players have absolutely loved using that Team of the Year item. For yourself as well, it must be a bit of an honour to say that you're in that Team of the Year. You made it into that on FC24.
Yeah, I mean, I think of always collectively as individual things, but of course being nominated in the start 11s and all these things is important, and I'm proud for that. But I'll let the experts analyse though, whatever.
Moving on to our next centre mid, to obviously partner you in the middle, we have the options of Patrick Vieira, Team of the Year icon, or John Stones?
No offence to Stones, but from items, Vieira is the best centre mid in the game, maybe. So I would go Vieira. He can do it all. He can attack, can defend, he can shoot. So yeah, I'd say Vieira comfortably.
You happy with that?
Yeah, we would trust them. I only can say that John, there's not many players that can play centre backs and hold the midfielder.
Yeah.
And it's, for me, it's great to have this polyvalence in football. So I think it's great, but yeah.
Well, there we are. That is the centre mid set. And we have one more position to join us in that three-man midfield. Team of the year, Kevin De Bruyne, or the hero, Yaya Toure. Is that a tough decision?
It is, because both they're legends of the club. But I don't know, maybe in the game, I think Kevin is...
Yeah,
no,
he's the best.
In the game, it's Kevin, assists, goals, I think maybe the pace, the...
He's got five-star weak foot, so he can use his right and left foot, and he's the best, so yeah.
And playing with someone like Kevin De Bruyne on the pitch, you know, if you find him, and then Haaland's making that run, he's got the ability to pick out a pass out from anywhere, really.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's his talent. He can find passes wherever no one can see. And also, it's a great help for him, the fact that Erling on front, he can put the ball in the air and head it, and he can put the ball in the space. So many options for him, and I think he's the striker he needs to assist that much. So I think both they do a great couple.
And now moving on to the attack. At right wing, we have that option of future stars Doku or the team of the year honorable mentions Bernardo Silva. Mateus?
I think I prefer Bernardo Silva here.
No, I disagree. I think at centre mid, Bernardo would be better, but on the wing, you say right winger, I'll go Doku.
Yeah, I agree with him. If we're talking about forward positions, of course, Jeremy is a pure winger. And if we're talking about managing the game and midfielder, Bernardo is a midfielder and is better. So I think each one in each position is better than the other.
Well, there we are then, Doku set in. And then on to that next position, we have the option of team of the year, Erling Haaland. Or that trailblazer, Alvarez.
Yeah, everyone knows Erling is a beast in scoring, and in the game will be even better than real life. But I have to say that Julian has adapted himself to many other positions, and is great. And he can play striker, he can play number 10, he played number 8. The other day he played number 6 with me. So I think big credit for him. But yeah, in terms of, I think in the game, Erling, yeah.
And Tex, why Erling Haaland? Why does everyone use him on the game?
He's tall, he's quick, he wins headers. But I do like Alvarez, though. He's carried me on FPL this year, like, completely. So I do like Alvarez, but I say Haaland, yeah, tall, quick, dangerous, hard to defend, so yeah.
We have one more position to pick from, and that's going to be our left wing spot, where we have the team of the week Phil Foden item or the triple threat Jack Grealish.
I think they're very different kind of players, but at the same time, very good in what they do.
Yeah.
I think Jack is more like a possession player, one against one, trying to attract people and then pass the ball, assist. And Phil is more like pure talent, more in between the lines, shots, assists. I'm going to pick Phil Foden just because of the age. I think what he's done with his age is more difficult, so I will go for him.
Mateus, you have a preference?
Yeah, I prefer Foden too, because I think in the game with the left leg is so good for the shoot.
There we are then. We have seen their team locked in. Let us know what you think down below in the comments, and we're going to head into a 2v2 game to test their ability on FC24.
All right, come on. This is a big game.
Okay, so as we're playing, we're going to see who can manage to get that win. It's me with Mateus and Tekkz with Rodri. We're the home team and you're in the away kit, okay? And we're also going to be asking some questions. Rodri, we've seen you so far this season come up with some massive goals.
What's it like
for yourself scoring in front of the Etihad crowd?
Well, always at home is great, you know, when you score. Of course, it depends on the moment. It's more special than others. But yeah, always when you score at home with your crowd, it's great. So it's definitely something I'm working on, trying to score more goals. And yeah.
Tekkz and Mateus are going to be playing in the EPL finals, which is a massive moment for them in their career. Would you have any advice to them to maybe deal with the nerves, even though they have been there plenty of times before?
Well, of course, I think the nerves is something natural. I think you have to learn to deal with them. And it's a matter of how many times you put your body or your person in this situation. So,
go on. Chance.
Hey, please. Settle down. Count on.
I thought we were going to have it then, Mateus.
Go on.
It is.
I'm scared.
No. Shoot. Yeah! Settle down, boys. Settle down.
He's trying to distract myself with the questions, but nothing. Yeah. No chance.
I got you.
So 1-0 to Tekkz and Rodri, the near post finish coming through. Tekkz, you've won the EPL finals before. You're back there again. How do you rate your chances with Matthias as your teammate this year?
I think we've got a good chance. I think we're favourites for the tournament. Yeah. So if we both perform to how we have, I'd say, our careers, then we got a good chance to win. But as long as we practice, what? Stop talking to me, actually.
Go on.
No.
Sorry.
I get nervous. Thank you.
A little bit more nervous there, maybe playing FC than you would be in a match on the Premier League?
Definitely. I don't have the control of anything, so I'm more nervous.
Well, there we have it. We've bounced back 1-1. It was a great finish there from Matthias. Matthias, it's going to be your first time playing in the EPL finals. Have you got a little bit of nerves going into it, or are you feeling confident?
No.
Chance? You cannot lose this one. You can.
Go on.
No! No, I'm confident. I think we have a good opportunity. We stay in quarter final now, so only 3 matches for the title.
I just want to play out juice. I've got a broken controller.
Good through ball.
No!
What a save. Rodri, you played a bit of FC24 yourself. Would you say there's anyone that's the best at FC24 in the Man City dressing room?
I don't know. Definitely there's better than me, 100%. But maybe the English guys, I think, Phil, maybe?
Phil, yeah, Phil does like his FC for sure. Chance from the corner. Knocks it down.
No.
Can we?
Oh.
Oh, we're looking really convincing right now.
Of a penalty there.
It's penalty, bro.
Tekkz, we don't want to give up kind of too much of the preparation that's going ahead for the EPL finals. But we've seen from yourself this year using that long ball pass play style a lot. Looking for those over-the-top through balls. Will that be something that you're looking to do again?
Well, of course. I think that's the thing that I'm really good at this FC, is like abusing the play styles. That's what I'll look to do again. Same with Kevin De Bruyne and like the finesse shots. But I'll be all over that. So yeah, if I can do that well, we'll have a good chance.
Mm-hmm. Chance coming through.
Go on.
The slip. For people at home who maybe haven't used that long ball plus play style, how do you use it and kind of get it to work accurately?
I think the best way to use it is to send your fullbacks. One second, let me just defend this.
Oh, the power! Ref, foul!
Foul!
Pen!
Where?
Oh, nice. He's gone back. I'll give it to you, Matthias. You'll be better at that free kick than me.
No.
Yeah.
No, come on.
It's not letting me move keeper.
I've seen you score them before.
Julian.
Chance. No. Oh,
yes. Counter attack.
So I think the thing you got to do is just send your fullback on a run and then time it as soon as the fullback sort of beats the offside line. And then you got to send it.
And is that where you're looking for the L1 triangle?
Yeah. Offside?
Well played, ref. Yeah. So it's all about the timing of the pass.
Well, 1-1. That was a good half. Back and forth action. Let's see how this second half goes on. Matthias, formations on FC24. Everyone wants to know what's the best custom tactics, what's the best formation. What do you think wins that crown?
The best formation.
Yes.
Best formation is, I think, the same for all the players is 4-3-2-1.
So I can't see.
And it's the best in the game. 4-4-2 is good too, but the best is so far 4-3-2-1.
There we have it. 4-3-2-1 is that best formation on FC24 as we try and find our way through. Slips in Erling Haaland. No. Can he get a finish? He can.
Where's the keeper?
That was you. I can't see.
So I think what's happened, Rodri, is if you push and hold the right analog stick in, you move the keeper.
Don't worry. I realised when the ball was in.
You'd be a bit unhappy with Ederson if you did that in a one-on-one scenario, wouldn't you?
With Ederson, no, I wouldn't be happy. If he goes out of the goal.
Rodri, can you tell me if there is a favourite season for yourself at Manchester City? You've had some great seasons, right? And last season we saw what Manchester City did.
No, it is. I mean, in terms of collective awareness and individual performance and everything, is last season, of course, by far. But we can do better.
And is that something that kind of Pep instills, that you won the treble last season and it's still, let's push on, let's go for more, let's always push for more? Is that something that Pep just drills in every single day?
Well, it's not a... In terms of, he doesn't ask us to win in that sense. It's just in the way we perform that, of course, give us chance to compete again, right?
Yeah.
To win again trophies and put us in the position in May to fight for everything. So this is kind of the point. He doesn't ask to score goals or to win trophies. It's a consequence of how we play and how we deal with every day. And this is the message.
slip through, chance. The movement.
No! Oh,
good defending.
Tackle.
Was that yourself, Rodri, or was that you, Tekkz?
No, that was Rodri.
Was it?
I can't see a thing.
Maybe you were the guy, the keeper.
It's beautiful, back post. Oh,
no,
footwork.
No. Sorry.
Come on.
Right.
Bro,
Doku.
Can't get out right now at the minute, can you, Rodri?
No.
The pressure's on.
Hey, Matty, 15 minutes, guys.
We see Haaland in the box. Oh.
No.
Oh, no. We run. There you go. I'm offside.
No.
Oh, good step. Here we go. Go on, Matthijs.
Yes. No.
Oh. Yes.
It's so difficult to get past some of the centre-backs.
Yeah.
Yeah, right, Matthijs, we've got 10 minutes remaining. We've got to hold on for this, OK?
Yeah.
Is there a sort of formation that you would normally switch to, Tekkz, in these sort of scenarios if you were trying to hold out a lead?
I'm a 4-1-4-1.
OK.
And I play around the DM with the long ball pass. That's sort of my tactic. I won't be switching it to right now because we need a goal.
I think I just kept my line.
Yeah.
Haaland with a power shot.
Ooh.
Oh, there's a power shot.
Yeah. Matthijs, are you the same? Do you use the 4-1-4-1 to see out games? Or?
No. I use it in the group stage, 4-2-1-3. It's like a strange formation,
What formation?
4-2-1-3.
I didn't even know I was in the game.
Yeah. It's new.
Added in this year. That's the one with the two CDMs and the cam. And then your left wing and right winger. All right, last chance maybe to seal the deal.
Nah, game over.
Goes in the box, Penn? No?
Nah, it's not.
We'll put it in. Up that post. Oh. Go on then.
Well done.
Finish.
No. Oh. Oh,
last attack.
Oh, ref.
Nah.
There we go.
Well, you didn't let me warm up, so that's what happens when you don't warm up.
Too many questions.
Well played, Rodri.
No?
Yeah.
Teammates, got to shake hands on that. But we managed to get that 2-1 win. You put on a good performance as well. And the ePremier League finals do kick off on the 23rd and the 24th of March, where you can come along and see Tekkz and Matthijs Bonanno and all the other Premier League clubs in action.